الحديث 38
حديث 38
عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال
From Abi Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, that he said
نهى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عن بيع الحصات وعن بيع الغرر
That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم forbade the selling of al-hasah and the selling of al-gharar
رواه مسلم
This is narrated by Muslim
المراد بالغرر المخاطرة والجهالة
What is meant by al-gharar here is to take the risk and to get involved in something that is unknown
وبيع الحصات
As for the selling of the sale that is called
هو
الحصات
هو أن يقول له ارمي الحصى حصل هي الصخرة الصغيرة
The word حصى is the little pebble or rock
ارميها أي شيء تقع عليه فهو عليك بكذا
So he says to the other person, throw this pebble or stone. If it falls on anything, then it is for you. I sell it to you with this price.
والأشياء هذه أسعارها مختلفة.
And those different items now that he's throwing at, the prices of them are different prices.
فهي قمار.
So this is now, it's just gambling.
وهذا يشبه بيع الملامسة والمنابذة كلها بهذه المسألة.
And this is similar to other types of contracts that are called ملامسة and منابذة.
لأن هذا كله من بيع القمار.
Because all of this now ملامسة is touching and منابذة is throwing.
منابذة أن أيضا نفس بيع الحصى هو أن يرمي شيء يقول أي شيء أرميه البائع يقول للمشتري أي شيء أرميه عليك فهو عليك بمئة دولار.
So منابذة is throwing similar to الحصى. The seller he throws the item on the buyer. And he says, when it falls on you, it is for you with this such and such price.
وأنت وحظك.
You and your luck. So again, it's gambling.
أرمي عليك شيئاً قيمته ألف دولار بمئة. تأخذه بمئة.
I throw on you something. It's worth $1,000, but then you can take it for $100 if it falls on you.
أو أرمي عليك شيئاً بمئة وأنت دفعت مئة.
And or I throw on you something that is worth $100. $100 and it is actually you paid $100.
وقد أرمي عليك شيئا قيمته دولار.
And I might throw on you something the price of it is just $1.
وأنت دفعت مئة دولار.
And you paid $100.
فهي مخاطرة.
So this is taking the risk now.
والملامسة كذلك.
The ملامسة the touching is the same.
أي شيء تلمسه فهو عليك بمئة دولار مثلا.
Anything you touch it's you pay for it $100 let's say.
كلها بيوع جهالة هذه.
All of these are types of sales conducted with unknown يعني things.
وفيها
involved.
مخاطرة ومقامرة.
Ignorance is involved. You don't know what you're getting, and there is also this factor of risk in there.
ومن ذلك بيع الشارد وهو الحيوان الهارب الضائع.
Part of that is the selling the animal that has been lost.
يعني لو جاك إنسان وقال أبيعك هذا الفرس بألف دولار في مشكلة
So someone comes and says I sell you this horse for $1,000 Is there a problem in this?
لا مشكلة
There is no problem
قد تشتريه وقد لا تشتريه
You might want to buy it or you might not buy it
لكن يقول لك عندي فرس ضائع
But he says to you I have a horse that got lost
وأبيعك إياه بثلاثمائة دولار.
I sell it to you for $300.
وقيمته الحقيقية ألف.
The real price of it is $1,000.
فأنت تدفع الثلاثمائة.
So you spend the $300.
وقد تجد الفرس.
And you might find the horse.
فتكون قد ربحت.
So you won now.
وقد لا تجد الفرس.
And you might not find the horse.
فتكون قد خسرت.
And then you lost.
فهو قمار.
So it is gambling.
هذا بيع الشاردي.
So this is the selling of the lost animal or the stray animal.
وكذلك شراء المغصوب.
Likewise, buying what is stolen, robbed.
Stolen سرقة.
نعم.
لا هو المغصوب مأخوذ غصبا غير المسروق.
Forcibly taken.
مع قهر.
مغصوب is the item that is forcibly taken by force.
يعني الفرق بين المغصوب والمسروق.
The difference between مغصوب and مسروق.
المسروق لا يقول السارق أنا سرقت، يخفيه.
The stolen, the thief, he doesn't say I stole it. He hides that.
الغاصب يأخذه بالقوة ويريك، يقول هذا عندي، ماذا تريد؟
But الغاصب is the one who takes it by force and he says this is mine, I have it. What do you want?
فبيع المغصوب كذلك لا يجوز.
So selling the item that is taken by force is also not allowed.
لأنه يشتريه من غير مالكه.
Because he buys it from other than the rightful owner.
إلا إذا اشتراه من الغاصب.
Except if he bought it from the one who is the one who forcibly took it, who took it by force.
لأن المغصوب كالشارد كالضائع.
Because the item that is taken by force, it is like the item that is lost or stray.
And ويدخل في هذا شراء الديون.
And included in this is the buying of debts.
مثلا أنا
for instance,
لي دين على الشيخ عبد المنعم وطالبه مثلا $5,000.
So for instance, he gave me a loan. I'm indebted to him for $5,000.
تشهدون لي بذلك؟
Do you witness to this? You testify to this?
طالبه.
So I will, you know, request that from me.
فأنا لا أستطيع أن أخذ منه الدين.
So he says he cannot take the debt from me.
إما لامتناعه.
Either because I don't want to give it to him.
وإما لفقره.
Or because I'm poor.
فيأتيني أحد الناس.
So someone from the people comes to me.
فيقول خذ ألفا.
He says to me, take $1,000.
وأنا قد أحصل 5,000 فقد لا أحصلها.
And I may be able to collect 5,000 from him, from me, or maybe I won't collect it.
فهو داخل في مغامرة.
So he is entering into risk, taking a risk.
وقد يكون هو مثلا له طريقة يجبر عبد المنعم أن يدفع.
And maybe this third person has his own way of forcing me, عبد المنعم, to pay up.
فتصور لو أعطاه أخذت الألف.
So imagine if I took the 1,000.
ثم الذي اشترى مني.
He took the 1,000. الدين. Then the one who bought this loan.
أعطاه عبد المنعم 5,000.
Then I give him the 5,000. Imagine this happens.
سيحزنني هذا.
I will be sad for this happening.
فالقصد أن هذه البيوع كلها بيوع محرمة لأنها لا تنبني على الصدق والأمانة أبدا.
So the point is that all of these types of sale contracts, all of them are prohibited because they do not include within them truthfulness and honesty and the like.
ويدخل في هذا كل بيع مجهول فإنه محرم.
And included in this every unknown type of a sales contract, for it is prohibited.
كان يأتيك شخص يقول أبيعك أثاث بيتي.
So someone comes to you as he says, I sell you the furniture in my home.
دون أن ترى.
Without seeing the furniture.
وتتفقان على مبلغ معين.
And you agree on a specific price.
فهذا لا يجوز.
This is not allowed.
لأنك لا تدري ما أثاث بيته.
Because you do not know what kind of furniture he has.
وكم يسوى.
And how much the value of it is.
فقد تدفع أكثر من قيمته.
You may pay more than the value.
وقد تدفع أقل من قيمته.
And you may pay less than the real value.
أو أبيعك ما في دكاني.
Or someone says, I sell you what's in my store.
كل هذا من بيوع الجهالة وهي محرمة.
All of this from the sales that have unknowns in them, things that are hidden.
ونهى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن بيع ما في بطون الأنعام.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم forbid selling what is in the bellies, the wombs of the animals, the cattle.
يعني يبيعه بقرة.
He sells him a cow, for instance.
مع الذي في بطنها.
With whatever that is in its stomach.
فهذا جائز.
This is allowed.
لأن هذا تبع.
Because this is a follow-up. What's in the stomach is just a follow-up of the selling the cow itself.
فيجوز بيع بقرة حامل.
So it is allowed to sell a pregnant cow.
لكن لا يجوز أن يبيعه الحمل وحده.
But it is not allowed to sell him the baby by itself in the stomach.
لأن هذا الحمل مجهول.
Because this baby is unknown.
Who ويقال له بيبي.
نعم.
ما صار بيبي بعد.
What's in the stomach? What do we call it? The fetus. الجنين يعني.
أي نعم. ما خرج الآن. هو الآن ليس بيبي.
فلا يعلم. It didn't come out. Still not a baby yet.
فهو لا يعلم هل هو ذكر أو أنثى.
So he doesn't know whether this fetus
وهل صحيح is أو مريض.
Male or a female. Healthy or sick.
وهل حي أو ميت.
Alive or dead.
فالبيع لا يجوز لأنه مجهول.
So this selling is not allowed because it's unknown. What you're selling is unknown.
من الحكمة so الابتعاد عن هذه المخاطرات.
It is wise to stay away from taking those risks and getting involved.
لأنه قطعاً سيكون أحدهما رابح والآخر خاسر.
Because definitely one of them will be winning and the other one will be losing.
ويحدث من العداوات والخصومات والبغضاء الله به عليم.
And there results because of that of enmity, disputes. And you know, hate and animosity. What Allah only knows what happens with that.
ولذلك يشترط في البيع.
This is why it is conditioned in the selling when you conduct a sales contract.
معرفة المبيع
is for you to know the commodity that is being sold.
ومعرفة الثمن.
The knowing also the price.
وأن يكون البائع والمشتري كلاهما عاقل بالغ راشد.
And that both the buyer and the seller, both of them are عاقل, sane, بالغ, reaching the age of puberty, عاقل بالغ and راشد.
يعني غير سفيه.
Someone who is wise knows how to deal. He's not like someone who is foolish or feeble-minded. He knows what he's doing.
فالقصد أن هذا يشترط في البيع حتى تصح بيوع الناس.
The objective then is that this is conditioned in the sales contracts so that the contracts between the people, those selling, will be valid.
ومعرفة الثمن هل هو معجل كله أو مؤجل كله أو بعضه معجل وبعضه مؤجل لابد أن يعرف
هذا. If it's all paid in cash or it's all delayed or some of it cash, some of it delayed, all of this must be made known.
فكل هذه الأشياء لرعاية مصالح الناس.
All of these things is for looking after the benefits, the interests of the people.
والله أعلم.
And Allah knows best.